Hi, in this video, I will show you how to deploy a demo that will enable you to query your data lake with natural language. I'm Lior Perez, I'm a solutions architect at AWS, and I've seen customers asking how to create a chatbot that can answer questions based on their internal data. Sometimes their internal data are structured data. And what I mean by structured data is simply data that are stored in tables. And these tables are stored in databases, and these databases can be stored in a data lake. Let's take a simple example. Imagine that you operate a web shop and you want to answer this question: who are the top 5 customers who bought products from French suppliers? To answer this question, you would ask a data analyst. The data analyst would first search the data catalog. They would do that to know which tables are required to answer the question. Then they would query the data, and to do that, they would write and perform a SQL query. And the last step would simply be to write the answer in natural language. So the demo that we're going to show you today is a demo that automates this whole process. But before jumping into the deployment of the demo, I would like to show you the user interface. So you will have a web interface in which you will be able to write your question and you will get the answer. And this answer will be pretty verbose, so you will be able to see what's happening behind the scene. We will get into the details of this verbose response later, but for now, I just wanted to show you that at the end, you get an answer to your initial question. And here you can see that we have the top 5 customers who bought products from French suppliers. Let's deploy the demo now. The first thing that you need to do is to go to the GitHub repository. It is in the AWS samples organization, and the repository name is Natural Language Queries for Data Lakes. In this repository, you will find a README in which you will get instructions for installation. We are going to use a Cloud9 instance, so you can go to your AWS account and go to Cloud9. Cloud9 will provide you an IDE to work with your code. Of course, if you're an advanced user, you can also use your own laptop. But here, for simplicity, we'll use Cloud9. You can start by clicking on Create Environment. You can give a name to your environment. And you can select an M5 large instance. When you're done, you can create your instance. And we still have one thing to do before using this instance. We need to increase the disk size. So to do that, you click on the instance name, you click on Manage EC2 Instance, then you select your instance, you click on Storage, and you can see here that the volume has a size of 10 gigabytes. And we're going to increase this to 20 gigabytes by clicking on the volume, selecting it, click on Action, Modify Volume, and you can change the size to 20 gigabytes. You can now go back to your Cloud9 instance. So you can click on Environments, and then you can open your Cloud9 environment. So as you can see, you have a terminal, and we're going to work in this terminal. We're going to check if our volume has been increased. So here we can see that the volume has not been increased yet. So we're going to reboot the instance to ensure that the modifications has been taken into consideration. Sudo reboot now. And this will reboot your instance. Okay, now we can check again. We can check again the volume size, and we can see here that we have our 20 gigabytes. So now we are going to clone the repository. So you can type the git clone command and paste the URL of the GitHub repository. Now that we have cloned the repository, let's look at the installation instructions. First, we're going to cd into the src folder. So of course, first we need to cd into our repository folder and then cd src. The next step is to create a virtual environment and install the dependencies. So we can just copy these instructions and paste them in the terminal. So this will install the Python dependencies for our code. Now the installation is done, we're going to launch the Streamlit server. So Streamlit is a Python library that helps data scientists write user interfaces in Python. So we're going to launch the Streamlit server. So we just have to paste the instructions streamlit run streamlit app.py --server.port8080. Here you can see that the Streamlit server has been launched on the port 8080, but we cannot access this port directly on Cloud9. So to access this Streamlit application, we're going to click here on preview and then preview running application. And you will see that the application will appear in this part of the window. To open it in a browser tab, we can click here on this button, pop out into new window. Then this will open the Streamlit application in a new tab. Now that our application is running, we need first to index the business data catalog. This is something that you will do only once, and this will look at your data catalog and store it in a vector database. This vector database will enable us searching the tables directly from natural language queries. Now the indexing is complete, we can ask our first question. So let's try with our first question. Who are the top 5 customers who bought products from French suppliers? As you can see, our demo works. We get an answer to the question here. We can see that the top 5 customers who bought products from French suppliers are One, IT, etc. Let's talk now about the workflow and how it is implemented in the code. The basic usage is just instantiating the DataGeny class and ask your question. So you can see that this is very simple. As we said before, the workflow is in 3 steps. The first step is the data catalog search. We need to find the tables that are required to answer the user question. The second step is the generation of a SQL query, and then we perform this SQL query. And the third step is to generate an answer in natural language. Now we're going to look at the first step, the data catalog search. And of course, before talking about data catalog search, we need to see where the data are stored. The data are stored in the source code folder, and it is in the example data folder. And in this example data folder, you will find several things. You will find a data folder which contains the databases in SQLite files. In this sample, you have 2 databases that are provided, the Chinook database and the Northwind database, Both of them are open source databases, and you can find information on what they contain on the internet. Of course, you can also use your own data. It can be in SQLite format, but also in any other type of database like PostgreSQL or Athena. You will just have to implement the connector in the Python code. The second thing that you will find is a metadata folder. And in this metadata folder, we will find the information about the data catalog. As we said before, you need to perform a search in the data catalog. This is the first step, so of course you need the data catalog. And this is what we will find in this metadata folder. In this metadata folder, you will find data catalog files. Each of these files will describe one of the tables that you have in your data lake. For instance, here we have one example of data catalog file. It tells that it's a table that is in the Chinook database. It gives the name of the table. Here it's the album table. We have a description. It tells that this table contains information about music albums. Then you have a description for each column. The title column is the name of the title of the album, the artist ID. Please note that a good description of the columns is very important, because sometimes the column names are not very explicit and nobody can guess what they contain. We also have some information about what the related table contains. This is very important because if you want to perform joins, you need to have information about the relationships between the tables. Now that we have a document for each table, we're going to use vector search. Vector search is a way to relate semantically a text, like the user question here, and some documents. The vector search will enable us to find the best matches. How are we going to use that? So let's get into the details of the step one, the data catalog search. The first thing is to find the database. And to do that, we will just perform a vector search to find the best match in the tables. And we will get the database name from the document that describes the table. The second step will be to split the question for the table search. Here, what we want to do is to find all the tables that are needed to answer the question. So we will ask the LLM, can you create a list of questions that will help us perform some search and find all the tables that we need? And here the LLM will split the question in four questions. The first one would be, what tables contain information about customers and their purchases? The second one would be, what tables contain information about products and their suppliers, including the country of the suppliers? So for each of the questions that we generated at the previous step, we're going to perform a vector search and we're going to ask for the three best matches. So here, for the first question, we see that we have three potential tables. For the second question, we have three potential tables, etc. And then the last step will just be to concatenate all the results. So here we got a list of tables that could be required to answer the question. Let's look now at the implementation in the code. All the code of the data catalog search is in the catalogquery.py file. I will let you go through this file, but I will show you a few extracts of this file. Here, this is the code for the vector search. As you can see, it's quite short. We use the Face library. Face is an in-memory vector database. We store the database in a file, so here we are just going to load it to be able to use this database. And then we just use the similarity search with core method, and this is all what you need to perform a vector search. Another extract of the code that I want to show you is the prompt that we use to split the questions. And basically, we say that we are going to perform a vector search in the data catalog to find the tables. Your task is to create a comprehensive list of questions that we will ask to the data catalog. So you see that the hard work is done by the LLM. So we're using generative AI at all the steps. The second part of the workflow is the SQL query generation. and we will also perform the SQL query after it has been generated. The code for this part is in the sqlquery.py file. What we're going to do in this step is to give to the LLM the schema of the tables, three examples rows from the tables, the data catalog document for each of the tables, and the question of the user. And we will ask it to generate a SQL query. This is the prompt that we use for a SQL query generation. So you can see that we ask, given an input question, create a SQL query to get from the database, etc. It is important that the SQL query complies with the dialect syntax. And we give the business data catalog information about the tables. We give the information about the table's schema and example rows. And we also give the input question. And we provide all this information in XML format. We also ask the LLM to answer in XML format. And this makes the parsing of the result easy. So this is what we get when we generate the SQL query. We get a SQL query, and we also get an explanation of the SQL query. This helps us check that the LLM has understood our question. The last step is to write the answer. So it's just generating an answer in natural language. To perform this step, we take all the information from the previous steps and we ask the LLM to generate an answer in natural language. So this is pretty simple. All the code is in the finalanswer.py file. Before concluding, I wanted to show you that this demo can also be deployed to the web, because for now, we just deployed it in a local instance in Cloud9. But if you want to make it accessible to your colleagues, for instance, you can deploy it to the web. All the information that you need to deploy are on the GitHub repo. You have a deploying section in which you can see a diagram of the architecture that will be deployed. And you have a CDK template. CDK is the Cloud Development Kit. It's an infrastructure as code library. And to use it, you just need to use the command CDK deploy. It will automatically deploy all the infrastructure. Your application will be deployed in a container in Amazon ECS, and you will also benefit from Amazon Cognito, which will provide user authentication. You have all the information that you need to try it yourself. Go to the GitHub repo, clone the code, and start experimenting now. Happy building!